Everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I have a what I eat in a day, and before I begin this what I eat in a day, I just want to put out a very important message that is important to me, at least when it comes to videos like this. Before I even get into my message, I do just want to say that the majority of the footage you guys are going to see was filmed yesterday. In all of the footage that I filmed, I look different in every single clip, and it's actually so funny because yesterday when I would eat, it was at like a different time of my day, obviously. So I was like doing different activities, and I changed my outfit 4 times yesterday to go along with the stuff that I was doing. So I look totally different in every single clip, which is funny. So I just want you guys to know it is all on the same day. I'm just dressed different. That's that. And also I got my nails done in the middle of the day yesterday. So my nails changed and I got my hair done today. So my hair is different in the video, even though I filmed it yesterday. So I know that this could look like it's from a bunch of different days, but like, I promise you, I'll put in the timestamps, I can show you my footage, it's all from the same day. I just wanna make sure that you guys know this is completely realistic, and me changing 4 times in a day, getting my nails done and getting my hair done is also very realistic. It's like a glow up in a day, if you guys will. So before I dive into the video today, I just want to send out a disclaimer for what I eat in a day videos, and this is going to be a trigger warning because I will be talking about food and yeah, like binge eating and stuff. So big trigger warning. First and foremost, I'm not at all a nutritionist, and I've been always hesitant to post these videos since videos of what I eat in a day are being reviewed by dietitians on YouTube. I don't want my video to be reviewed because I don't want anyone to even like take advice from this. It's just what I've been doing, and it's been what makes me feel really, really good. So like, my body right now too isn't like my dream body or anything, but it is a body that is healthy for me. I can accomplish all of my workouts in it, and I don't hate myself. So I'm starting to love this body that I'm in, even though it's not the body that I'm used to and not the body that you guys see a lot. And trust me, you don't hold back in the comments with telling me that. It is a body that I'm growing into as a woman, and I'm learning to love it every single day, and this is how I do so. Also, a lot of my other what I eat in a days on my channel were always centered around cutting or dieting or being vegan. I no longer do any of that. I try not to cut. I try not to diet whatsoever. And that's simply because I found that with me, whenever I restrict in any sort of sense, I will always binge. And I am really proud of myself for the lack of binge that I've been doing the past couple of months. And it's because I don't restrict myself. So I eat when I'm hungry and I stop when I'm full. And if I'm really, really hungry, I will eat until I'm satisfied. And I don't shame myself for it. So I really do try to eat intuitively and not restrict at all. For me, my main goal is no restriction and to get over binge. And if you guys are confused, I made a whole podcast episode about this. It's called Does Anybody Have a Healthy Relationship with Food? And it's on my podcast Manifest with Tori D. Simone. And then the very last thing that I'm going to put out there is, just because this is what I'm eating does not mean that this is what you guys need to be eating. I also included clips of me eating the foods because I know that some people like that, and I'd love it if you guys would eat with me during this video. Again, thank you guys so much. I know food can be a sensitive topic for some of my viewers, and I just want you guys to know that you're not alone. I don't really open up about this on my YouTube channel, but I do a lot on my podcast. And if all of this, what I'm saying, seems over dramatic and crazy to you, then consider yourself lucky and blessed, and I hope you always have that mentality. So yeah, I love you guys so much, and thank you, Kara, for working with me in this video. I think it's a very important one, and let's get on to the video.
Okay, so this is how I make my matcha. I use the Vital Proteins matcha collagen, and I use Vital Proteins vanilla collagen latte. I use water in my matchas. I used to use oat milk, but it actually got me too full, so I started using water. Then I use maca powder, and I put in a ton of cinnamon. I love cinnamon. And coconut butter. And the way that you get your matcha really creamy with water is, one, by using collagen. It makes it really frothy. And two, I put it all in a blender and I blend it on high for a minute. All right, let's make this matcha. I have matcha pretty much every morning, but some days I'll have an iced coffee with cold brew, but this is how I make it. So I just put the hot water in a blender. I add in all of those powdered ingredients that I just showed you guys, put it on high for about a minute or so, pour it in, and look at how creamy and frothy it is. I look forward to this drink every single morning.
Hey guys, it's me interrupting the video to talk about today's sponsor, Care Of. So I've worked with Care Of multiple times before. They are such an amazing company to work with, and I'm so honored to be working with them again. You guys will see that I keep this box of my Care Of vitamins on my countertop every single day, and I typically take my vitamins after my matcha when I get back from the gym. So I've been working with Care Of for a long time, which means that I've been using their products for about 2 years now, and I wholeheartedly believe in them. So what's really cool about Care Of is that you take a test online, and then they make these perfect little vitamins that are perfectly packaged for you, and they're personalized to your test answers that you say is most important to you. What's really cool about their test is that it feels like you're getting one-on-one attention from a nutritionist. So for me, the stuff that I chose was most important was digestion and my hair, because I'm really trying to have some healthy hair these days, and you guys know me and my digestion, it's been a journey. So this is what the packs look like. It says your name on it. For me, obviously it says Tori. This is really great because when I go to like Sea Isle, or if I'm traveling or anything, which I'm not really traveling these days, but I do go to Sea Isle because I have another studio down there. Whenever I do go, I can just grab however many packets I'm going for. So if I'm going for 3 days, I get 3 packets, and boom, I have all my vitamins with me. My vitamins are like really packed. So I have, obviously these big boys are fish oil, and then I have other ones just for digestion. Obviously this year looks much different than years past, and I think the gift of health and wellness is amazing for the holidays. I know that personally I would love to get a subscription to Care Of, because it's like the gift that keeps on giving. If you guys wanna try out Care Of for yourself and take the quiz to see what vitamins are best for you, I'm gonna have a code down in my description box for 50% off your first order, which is an incredible deal. And again, thank you Care Of for sponsoring this video, and now let's get on to what I eat for breakfast. I just got back from the gym and it was really good. We lifted legs today, well, more glutes. So breakfast, so this is what I do for breakfast. Every single day my breakfast is a little bit different. I try to eat as intuitively as possible. Today I want a smoothie and eggs and bread. So we're gonna do that today. So for my smoothie, I'm gonna put in a banana, and I'm gonna do some spinach with, this is chia seeds and flax seeds, protein powder. This is plant-based protein powder, vanilla. And I'm also gonna throw in some peanut butter and cinnamon, and I blend it with almond milk. You can use water, you can use any milk that you want. I just prefer almond because it's a lot lighter in smoothies than oat milk. Oat milk is so creamy that it's almost like too rich for today for me. But some days I do use oats, some days I use coconut water. Today I'm doing almond. And then I'm also gonna make eggs. So I'm just probably gonna scramble 2 eggs, just like brown eggs. And then I have these vegan everything bagels. I'll probably just have one, like half of one. And then on that I'm gonna put ghee, and you guys will see that I use balsamic glaze on everything. So I'm gonna throw some balsamic glaze on there. Okay, here we go. So I put half of the bagel in the toaster, fill up my blender again, spinach, banana, flaxseed, cinnamon, protein powder, peanut butter, almond milk, everything that I just showed you guys, put it all in, and I blend. This was like about a minute that I blended on, I think a 5.
I put my eggs in the pan, and you guys are probably gonna roast me of how I scramble my eggs in the pan. I don't know, it just feels right sometimes. Then I just, you know, beautifully plate my scrambled eggs. I put ghee on the half of the bagel, and then I throw on balsamic vinaigrette over top, and that's it.
Okay, and that's my breakfast. Again, it's different every day. I try to eat as intuitively as possible. Sometimes I go to the gym fasted, sometimes I eat. Like today I just had my matcha, and then I went yesterday, I had a bowl of oats because I woke up starving. I wasn't that hungry until after I got done my workout, and I was like, oh my God, I could literally eat a horse. So here I am with my breakfast, and yeah.
So I did want to include in this video footage of me actually eating the meals. I know that this helps a lot of girls out there, and I'm just really happy to start a conversation about something that I think is important and that has actually affected me over the past couple of years. Again, I talk about this a lot over on my podcast, and I recommend to listen to that rather than me explain it over just a voiceover. But if this can help just anyone eat a meal with me or make you feel better about eating three meals a day, if you struggle with binge, which is what I struggled with, I'm still getting over it, but I'm definitely on the right path. And yeah, so I just hope that these little clips of me eating will help you guys, and you guys can eat with me. So this is my breakfast. It was super good and I loved it.
Okay, so now it's time to eat lunch. It's 1:30 when I'm starting to make lunch. So I'm gonna make this like chicken pita that I've been eating every day, and it's really good. So first thing that I do is I take, or I use these pita breads. This is the Joseph's original pita bread. Oh, it's pretty good. This is my favorite hummus. I take the Wegmans caramelized onion hummus. I use half of an avocado. It looks brown because it was in the bag, but it's green under that. Feta cheese, and this is chicken. I honestly just use like canned chicken. You can definitely get like chicken breasts and boil it. I don't know what's up. There we go. You can boil it. But this is just so much easier, and I'm all about efficiency here. So in the chicken, I just mixed it with the Primal Kitchen mayonnaise made from avocado oil. And then I'm going to top it with balsamic glaze, and I'm going to have an orange on the side.
So this lunch is really good, and it's really easy to make. It keeps me pretty full, and I enjoy it. So I spread the hummus on either side of the pita. I switched the camera in a second because I realized that I'm just like filming on the wrong side. I slice the avocado and put it in as well. Like I said about the chicken in the clip before, you could definitely get like a chicken breast and boil it. That would be much less processed than canned chicken. But I don't know, for me, man, like the texture of this chicken is better than the texture of like a boiled chicken that you then shred with a fork. For me anyway, I just prefer this, but if you would rather do like tuna or, you know, like an actual shredded chicken breast, that would be awesome as well. And then I just fold in some cheese, balsamic glaze, and here I am just cutting up an orange, and that's my lunch. Now, when I had this meal the day before this, I actually had two pita pockets because I was so hungry. I had a little smaller of a breakfast that morning. I wasn't like as hungry in the morning, but I was pretty hungry by the middle of the day. So I had two, and then this day I just had one. I typically watch TikToks while I eat, and that's really kind of like the only time that I let myself go on social media during work days when I'm eating. So it feels like a little reward. It's really fun for me. I also just found out in that TikTok when I was like smiling that Rihanna and ASAP Rocky are dating, and I think that's such a power couple. Love that for them. So after this clip, what I actually ended up doing this day was going to the studio and setting up all of the holiday decorations. So I was eating around 1:30, and then I got home in the next clip at 5:30. So that was about like 4 hours. And typically I would have had a snack in between that time, but on this particular day, I just didn't have time for a snack, or like the access of a snack, because I was at the studio. But if I were to have a snack, I most likely would have had an apple and peanut butter, or just an apple, or like a rice cake with banana on top of it.
and some peanut butter, but one of those, maybe carrots and hummus, but most likely like an apple this day, like I said. And yeah, that's probably what I would have had, but because I didn't have a snack, I was really hungry when it came to dinner around 5:30. And yeah, I'll show you guys my dinner in a second. It's like one of my favorite dinners, but I'm just eating these oranges. They are so good right now. They're pretty in season. I love them. Again, I'm just watching TikTok while I eat. I think TikTok is so funny. My TikTok is toristerling if you guys want to follow me. I posted my matcha recipe on there once, but that's pretty much it. I don't really post anything fun. I just scroll and laugh and, you know, do the things that you do on TikTok. So yeah, these oranges, pretty good. I don't really know what else to say right here, but I want to continue the duration of this clip. But yeah, like I said, if you guys want to hear more about my in-depth relationship with food and stuff, I recommend to go over my podcast, Manifest with Tori D. Spoon. Okay, done.
Okay, so now we're going to do dinner. It's 5:30 and I'm starving. So because I'm really hungry, we're going to make a burrito bowl. I love burrito bowls. They're my favorite dinners and they're really easy and I really like how I make mine. So because I'm really hungry, I definitely want it to be high volume. So I'm going to fill up with Caesar romaine. And then these are all the good stuff. So this is just jasmine rice that you microwave. Again, we're about efficiency here. I got queso. This is the Siete queso. Oh my God, my camera. Anyway, this queso, so good. And then I'm gonna use black beans and corn. This is exactly what I get at Chipotle. And I'm gonna make guac. This avocado sounds feels right. I'm gonna make guac and I have lime to go in it. And I'm gonna season everything with the chili lime from Trader Joe's. And I always like to put the Chipotle vinaigrette over my bowls, but when I make these at home, I use the Brianna's blush wine vinaigrette. So good. There's something about like this combo that just works. And then I always like to dip my burrito bowls in with chips. So I got the Siete dairy-free nacho grain-free chips.
So this dinner, I was really craving Chipotle. I got my nails done this day, and every time I get my nails done, I really want Chipotle because there's a Chipotle right next to my nail salon. But my goal for this week was to not eat out or get any fast foods like Starbucks, Dunkin', Chipotle, anything like that. So I was like, oh, I'll just make a burrito bowl at home. I was really craving it, and I really wanted one. So this is how I make it at home. I'm just heating up some corn and black beans. You guys will see that I'm really not like a chef in the kitchen whatsoever. I like my meals very simple because if they're complex and I feel really overwhelmed, I typically won't make them and I'll just end up ordering out. And like I said, this week my goal was to not order takeout. So I wanted to make sure that these were meals that I could make and that I would be really satisfied with. And like I said, because I was really hungry, I tried to bulk up more on lettuce rather than like the beans and the corn and the rice and everything. But if I wanted seconds, I definitely would have had them. But after this serving, I was completely stuffed. So I had 3 full meals today. I didn't have any snacks. I typically would have had one snack, but my matcha in the morning is really filling because I put that coconut butter in it. So that really fills me up for a pretty good duration of the morning. And I just want to remind you that every single day is different for me with eating. Some days I eat way less than this. Sometimes I eat more than this. It really just depends a lot, honestly, on my cycle, my exercise, and just generally my lifestyle for that day. And sometimes the days to follow it. But yeah, that's my dinner.
I know it probably sounds like a really weird combo, but it works. And it's just like my take on the Chipotle bowl that I always get. I normally don't get lettuce at Chipotle, but I just added the lettuce in because I'm really hungry and it just adds in more volume. But if I want like seconds, I'll definitely have it. That's like my big thing is like I just don't really restrict anymore. So whatever I want, I eat. If I'm hungry, I eat. If I'm full, I stop. So I'm gonna eat this. I really wanna watch a Christmas movie while I eat this. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you guys all enjoyed it. Have a great rest of your day. Be sure to follow me on Instagram @toristerling_. My TikTok is toristerling_ and my podcast is Manifest with Tori D. Simone. And I will talk to you guys very soon. Love you guys. Bye.